Hey, what's going on, everyone? Happy Monday. I hope everybody's had a great start to the week. It's Rod coming at you again from Points Blank Travel. I want to welcome everyone to the channel. Hey, if you're into credit cards, points and miles, and interested in learning how to travel for free or with little money out of your pocket, please do me a favor. Subscribe to the channel. If you hear something in this video that you like, please like the video. Again, I'm going to be coming at you with some more knowledge, free knowledge. You don't even have to pay for it. But you know, usually on Sundays, and I was going to record this video yesterday, usually on Sundays, I sit back and I review a lot of data, a lot of numbers, a lot of figures, a lot of information from RT Infinite, which is my parent company for all of the small companies that have under umbrella. You know, I have RT Holdings, which is the investments. I have the Facebook page. I have the Facebook VIP group, have the Instagram channel, and I have the YouTube channel, which I'm coming at you right now. And a lot of times I sit back and I review this data, and it really hit me yesterday. You know, it hit me. I'm looking at all these numbers. I'm looking at all these figures. I'm looking at my investments. But one thing that stood out was I'm sitting on over 500,000, a half a million travel points and miles, man. And I was so excited, you know, and to be honest, I don't even have a plan for what I'm going to use these miles for. I don't even have a plan of where I'm going, what I'm going to do. But I did want to shoot out a quick video and just say, hey, you know, these are some of the things I'm thinking about. You know, I looked at my American Express membership rewards points, 154,127 points. And I'll be straight up with you. I'm planning on using these points for international travel. I don't know where I'm going. I don't know where I end up at. But wherever I go, if I'm flying 15 plus hours, I will be flying first class or business class, lay flat. Give me a mimosa. Give me a cocktail. Give me some to eat. You know, that's what I plan on doing. So I'm definitely going to keep building up those points. And next, I looked at my Chase Ultimate Rewards. I have about 65,275 points. And before I go any further, with these points that I'm talking about, I'm sitting on over a half a million points, a half a million. I wish this was money. If this was money, oh my God, I wouldn't even be able to do a video. But I'm sitting on 516,292 travel points and miles. If this was $516,000, I wouldn't be able to compose myself. I wouldn't be doing this video. But since it's points and miles, I guess I'll be all right. But 65,275 Chase Ultimate Reward points, that is plenty. That's at least two nights in a Park Hyatt anywhere around the world. It's four nights. One of the trips I'm looking at taking, and every time I go to San Diego, I stay with my daughter, but I at least want to spend one night, just one night at the Grand Hyatt on the bay, overlooking the bay, relaxing close to the Gaslamp District. I do plan on doing that. Capital One Venture Miles, I'm sitting at 70,811, and I'm really trying to build this up, because if I end up going somewhere like Miami to the Fontainebleau, they're not part of any hotel chain, they're not part of Hilton, Marriott, or Hyatt, and if I'm not mistaken, they ran about $300 to $400 a night, and if I can, I want to build up enough points where that trip will be taken care of via Venture Miles. So I'm definitely trying to build it up. My Citi Advantage card, my American Airlines Advantage cards, I'm up to 54,597 points. That's good for two economy round trip tickets anywhere domestically, anywhere in the United States, or good for at least one one-way trip internationally, or a round trip first class trip. So I'm definitely looking forward to keep building up those miles. I use that card sporadically. Next, I have my Chase World of Hyatt card, 29,916 miles. I need 84 more points to hit 30,000. That's another two nights at the Grand Hyatt in San Diego, or one night any Park Hyatt around the world. I'll eclipse that this month, but I'm so excited about that. My Hilton Honors card, 117,415 Hilton Honors points. They just sent me an email yesterday. Man, they sent me an email yesterday, and they're giving me 5 extra points for everything. So that card has actually went back in my wallet. You know, I'm not a huge fan of Hilton, but I'm going to find a way to be a fan of Hilton, because 11 points, grocery stores, gas stations, restaurants instead of 6, 8 points for everywhere else I'm using. I'm going to blow this car up, but I can only spend $1,000. So after $1,000, I'll scale it back. I really don't care. But hey, you best believe this isn't even all the points I have. I have United, I have Southwest, I have a couple other points. My Bank of America Premium Rewards card. They're you know, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 points. Not really a lot to brag about, but I'm so excited. A half a million points. I've done a couple of videos, my road to a million. I said I wasn't gonna spend any more points till I hit a million. I don't know, maybe I'll hit a million, maybe I won't. But remember, I started out probably in 2017. I wanna say 2017. Whatever I'm doing right now, you can do it too. You can do it. Just sit back, take heed to the knowledge that's coming at you. I was actually not even educated as the way I'm trying to educate everyone else. The bonuses, the sign-up bonuses. You know, I'm sitting here saying, hey, I'm at a half a million. I'm doing a video about a half a million. But if you play it right and do the sign-up bonuses, you could have been a half a million in 3 months. So please remember, with that being said, you could be at a half a million in 3 months. Shoot for the moon. And if you don't make it, you'll be amongst the stars. Have a great evening, everyone.